Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming. This is a beginner course on Bazel, and I'm Benjamin. I work at EngFlow. I'm happy to be.
Sorry, there's like a couple more spots right here if y'all want to, somebody wants an actual people.
Yeah, you can sit here if you want. Yeah. I'm not too dangerous. I'm very lucky to be assisted by two lovely assistants today. So Jay is a colleague of mine, and Pete is also a colleague of mine, so they'll be pitching in later. And basically the main format for this boot camp is that I have some introductory material, so I'll talk for approximately half an hour about some fundamental Bazel concepts and also history, so you can get a feel for what Bazel is about and from whence it came. And then the most important part is that we have some practical exercises with a code lab where you can actually practice writing some Bazel build metadata files and running Bazel on your machine. So I'm glad that everyone seems to have brought their laptops. So this material is an updated version of some stuff from Google by an engineer named Danna Kelmer. So I'm very glad that she and others went to the effort of creating this a few years ago, and we benefit a lot from it. So the main thing I kind of object to is the fact this is called a boot camp. Like, it's one of those words that the tech industry especially has just like watered down into meaningless mush as an analogy, right? Like, we're not going to like make you get up at 4 a.m. and do physical training in the cold or anything like that. Instead, we're going to let you sit in this comfortable conference room with a nice view of Manhattan and then feed you lunch later. A boot camp, it isn't really, but I guess it is alliterative. Perhaps the one similarity that it does have with real military boot camp is that the goal of military boot camp, we're not going to subject you to the uniform code of military justice, but you kind of get you into a military way of thinking, which is different from civilian life. And Bazel sometimes requires its own kind of adjustment of perspective. It really wants you to think the way it thinks. So you might have to stand back, take a step back every once in a while and make sure you're grasping the larger picture. All right, so this is kind of the overview of my introductory presentation. As I said, I'm going to talk about the fundamental Bazel concepts and a little history because that's interesting, and then we'll dive into the code lab. So let's talk a little bit about what even is Bazel. So Bazel is a build system. You probably know that much. But what is build system? Well, when we write source code, it somehow has to get turned into something that the computer can understand, and the build system is a tool to orchestrate that. So there's many different programming languages and programming ecosystems, and they all usually have like some sort of build system. So like the oldest one kind of in the world is Make, which many people still use for some things, other build systems you think of like Maven, which is often used with Java, or CMake, which is strongly associated with C++. And many of these build systems are like, if not exclusively for one programming language, like have their best support for or are targeted at a particular programming language. So Bazel is like that in that its job is to orchestrate the transformation of source code into something the computer can run. But it takes a slightly different tack than these a lot of the language specific ones. So kind of what the main goals or features of Bazel are supposed to be probably the most important one is fast correct. So maybe you've seen the Bazel website, like correctness is right up there. And so what is correctness for a build system means? That means every time you go and run a build command in Bazel, you should get the correct result. So like out of date file should not be linked with newly built ones. Incremental build should always be correct. So if you do a clean build and then you modify one file and then revert it back, you should always get the same result. And that's also linked with the idea of reproducibility, which means the same inputs to the build should always yield the same outputs. Correctness is important, first of all, for developer happiness and sanity, because things are so frustrating to be debugging some weird bug and then you turn out it's because not any problem in your code, but because the build was incorrectly built by the build system. And once you're in the world of where your builds are always correct, you never want to go back to the back old days. So I think this is a very important feature. But it's also the foundation for other parts of Bazel, in particular speed. So I one engineer who I work with always said, you can make a correct thing fast, but you can't make a fast thing correct. Which I think is a pretty wise maxim software engineering. And building on Bazel's focus on correctness, you can do a lot of interesting things to make builds fast, like maximizing your parallelism, distributing builds across machines, which is into the cloud, which is what we do at EngFlow, and also like maximizing the incremental your returns. And some of the other features of Bazel is that it tries to be universal. So that both means like the platforms you can run on. So if we're going to be honest, it's really very much best supported on Linux and secondarily other Unix-y BSD systems like macOS and Windows will probably cause you some suffering. But you know, the vision is that it should work on any platform, and it should be able to build any programming languages. And you should, if you want to combine them, that should work. So you should be able to have your Java program, which links some JNI thing, and the JNI thing is a whole, you know, tens of thousands of C++ files. That should be possible. And Bazel should also provide a uniform interface to all those languages. So if you want to build a Go executable, it's basically the same syntax if you're going to like build some sort of Python deployable artifact or a web app. And so the user of Bazel, which can be a human, but also like a CI system or some sort of kind of other developer infrastructure, doesn't have to be aware of language specific build tools or conventions. Bazel will abstract over all those things. And part of the way that Bazel.
Sorry, I'm going to try to record this.
And this attractive Kleenex box, yes. All right. part of the way that Bazel does that is that Bazel knows about some programming languages by default, in basically the ones that people use, so Java, C++. But it also has a whole extension language that you can use to write your own rules to extend to any programming language or build process that you might need. And so we're not going to talk about that part very much in this session, but it's the entire subject of Jay's talk in the afternoon is writing rules. That's kind of like a whole another topic. All right, so where did Bazel come from? So Google, but more specifically, Google has a lot and a lot of C++, and like a very long time ago, they built it all with a single makefile. And so that was kind of annoying, as you can imagine. So they had a system to generate the makefile or multiple makefiles, and they put it in this like syntax, which is now the a predecessor of Bazel's metadata. And eventually they kind of like replaced all the components of this system. So the make was replaced with a different execution system, and the config generator was added to Bazel. And one thing which comes up is, so in Google, Bazel is called Blaze. And so they're almost interchangeable, but you kind of have to be aware of that distinction. So finally, in 2015, Blaze was open sourced as Bazel, and that's what we have now. All right, so actually getting into Bazel concepts, there's kind of like two major kinds of files that Bazel reads its information from: workspace files and build files. So a workspace file is how you mark what's called a Bazel workspace, which is a kind of an entire Bazel project. So normally this is like one per repository. So the classic example is Google just has one repo and it's one workspace. But it's Bazel also has mechanisms for you to build multiple workspaces, or have artifacts or builds which depend on things in multiple workspaces, if that's the way you want to work. And so you have this workspace file, and it sits at the root of your project, probably your repository, and it kind of just tells Bazel that this is the root of the repository. And so you could have multiple workspaces if you want. Probably the more important one, which you do a lot more commonly, is the build file. And so the build file is actually how you're telling Bazel what you want to do in your project. And a repository can have anywhere from one to tens of thousands of build files. And if a directory has a build file, the directory is called a package in the parlance of Bazel. And then within the package, the build file creates any number of targets. And targets are kind of like the smallest buildable concept in Bazel. So an example of a target is a binary or a test or a library. Binaries and tests are like top level things you would probably actually try to build. And the libraries are intermediate artifacts, which will be linked somewhere in the middle in the tree. Build files are written in a language called Starlark, which is a sort of very restricted subset of Python. We'll see a few examples. It basically looks like a bunch of Python function calls. Here's an example of a Bazel workspace with a few packages, so we can see what this looks like. So there's a workspace file at the top, which tells you that this is a root of the Bazel project. And then there's a build file. And so that's the build file for the root package. And then within the root package, there's a sub package called animations. We can see that because it has a build file. And then within the animations package, there's browser package. So one thing that's a little interesting is that you can also see there's this source directory, but since it doesn't have a build file, it's not its own package. Instead, it belongs to the higher level animations package. And then lastly, there's another utils sub package. And so the way you refer to packages and targets within Bazel is a syntax called a label. And so you use this a lot both on the command line in order to instruct Bazel on what you want to get out, and also within build files to enumerate relationships and dependencies between different components in the build. So here's an example of sort of the full expressivity of the label syntax. First of all, there can be this @ followed by name, and that's the name of the repository that you want to refer to. So that's the way you can refer, or workspace that you want to refer to. So if you want to refer, this is the way you can refer to some other workspace. And then after the slash slash is the path to the package that you're referring to, and then a colon, and then the target within the package. So this would be looking for something, a target called draw circle within the animation slash utils package. And we have this annotated thing. So repository, package, target. Very satisfyingly hierarchical. Most of these parts of the label you can omit, and Bazel will infer it from the context. For example, if you don't include the workspace name, Bazel will just assume that you are referring to the workspace that you are currently in. You can just start it with //. And you can also drop the target part. You don't have to put something after the colon. And in that case, Bazel will assume that the last component of the package is the target that you want. And if your working directory is in a package with a particular target that you want to build, then you can just say colon the target. So it's a pretty expressive and flexible syntax. So let's actually go and look inside of one of these build files that we've been seeing the metadata for. Thank you so much. All right, so you can see the Python like syntax. So the first thing you see is this declaration called the package declaration. And that obviously says that we are defining metadata for a package. And you can pass a few different things to this package function, but by far the most common and probably the only one you'll ever need is you can set the visibility of the package. And the visibility in Bazel is a way to allow only certain code to depend on the targets that you're writing. So this means that you can have internal targets that only other internal projects or something can depend on. And you can sort of carefully only expose the public APIs or targets that you want to. And then there's this load statement. So that's telling Bazel that we want to load, bring into scope a particular rule set that we're going to use in this build file. So this is kind of the equivalent of a Python import statement. And so we're loading something from the TypeScript, rules TypeScript repository, and we're loading something called TS library. And so that unsurprisingly just declares a TypeScript library. And then finally, at the bottom of this build file, we actually have the declaration of a target called lib, which is a TypeScript library. So the name attribute tells you the name of the target. So yes. And so all these things before the equal sign are attributes of the role. So there's one attribute which every target must have, which is the name, because you need some way to refer to it. But basically all of the other possible attributes depend on the rule type that you're doing. And there's some like common conventions. For example, most roles require you to pass in some sort of sources, but depending on the role, the appropriate thing could be like a C++ file or a TypeScript file or any other kind of source code. And you know, we can imagine that the tsconfig rule or attribute is quite specific to the TypeScript library here. And then there's the dependencies list here, and that actually tells us what refers to another target and tells us that this TypeScript library needs some functionality which is in that other target. All right. As you can see, there's quite a few examples of labels within this file, right? So you have the TypeScript config that's referring to a TypeScript config file, which is in the same package. And then this is a more full example of a label referring to this /node package within the ngdeps repository. Any questions? All right. So just kind of summarize the hierarchy here of Bazel concepts. We have workspace at the top level, which has any number of packages, which are in this nested hierarchy defined by build files in the file system. And then within each build file can define any number of targets. So how do we actually, once we have these build files, how do we actually go and ask Bazel to do stuff? And so unsurprisingly, we are going to run the Bazel executable. And Bazel has quite a few subcommands, but probably the most important one is the build subcommand. And it just takes a path to the label that we want to go and build. And in basic users, that's pretty much all you need to know to invoke Bazel. And if you go and run that and it's successful, then Bazel will produce the output that you were asking for. And that will end up in a directory called Bazel bin in the root of your workspace. And so this is one thing that might be a little different from other build systems they're used for. Bazel is very into having the output directory, which builds right into, separate from the source source tree. So Bazel is very much not going to want to emit your outputs like into the same directory that you're writing the source code. And instead, it has a separate output directory that it expects everything to go in. And the way you kind of find that is finding the Bazel bin directory in your workspace root. And that has a hierarchy which is parallel to the package hierarchy. So if you build something in my package, then there'll be a subdirectory of Bazel bin called my package, which has your binary or whatever within it. And sort of the idea is that it formalizes the fact that the build should not mutate the sources. And if we want to do a clean build, we just delete the entire output tree and we know that we are kind of back to ground zero because the build won't have mutated the inputs. All right, so one other thing to say I know about build files is that you may have noticed we have to write a bunch of information about the source code that we're building, in particular, the dependencies. And so this can be kind of an irritant because, you know, we already have to record the dependencies of our source code within the source code, whether with hash include lines or import statements or any other ways that languages allow us to have dependencies. And so you basically, the dependencies of source code have to be in sync with the build file. And this does seem like it's something that could be automated. And of course, someone has gone and do that. So there is a tool, an open source tool called Gazelle, which she actually wrote, it can be used for generating build files. And it was originally intended for only targeted at Go, but now these days it has a whole plugin interface which allows it to generate for many different programming languages. And in this code lab, you'll use it to generate Go, but just be aware that that is a thing. All right, so that kind of concludes my introductory remarks, and we're ready to get started with the practical exercises, which is good because, let's be honest, you learn by getting down and dirty with the code and not not listening to people drone on from bullet point slideshows that would make Edward Tufte mad. And so we have a code lab here at EngFlow/codelab. And it's actually kind of funny that it's called a code lab because we actually wrote all the code for you. You're just gonna be writing the build files. And so it's a very simple multilingual application to kind of demonstrate the polyglot nature of Bazel. So there's a Go server, and there is a Java client for that server, and then there is an integration test that sort of pulls all those things together and runs a smoke test. And so if you pull this, once you have pulled down this repository, you'll see in the README kind of the steps that we'll be taking. In particular, you'll be starting by just getting a Java program that prints out "Hello World" in step one. And if you have any question or concerns, please raise your hand, and we'll try our best to help you.
Yeah, I have a question.
Yeah.
Does anyone have a spare laptop by any chance? That's all right.
You want to pair with someone?
Yeah, I'll pair with someone. I have Garrett. Thank you. I'm pairing with Garrett now. Thanks.
Work.
Oh, we're all going to make friends too.
Heck yeah.
I'm just getting set up here.
I knew I should have backed up my data when I had the chance.
Yeah, that is tragic. Oh, I'm completely new to Bazel, just so you know.
Yeah, yeah. I've dabbled a little bit.
Okay. Same true information side.
So you got the
don't want to have a Bazel.
It's been like 5 months of this, and you know, in like 6 months.
Okay, so we're following the stack.
Really long.
Oh, nice. At the Java source page. Wow. Okay. Can't build. Add a.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah. Okay. I think I see what we need to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. The Java source main Bazel Bootcamp build. Cool. Add a Java binary tag for the hello
world.
Sure. Binary using the command. Okay.
Cool.
That's pretty cool. So first, added that. Add a Java binary target.
That's fair.
Do you know how to add a Java binary target right off the bat?
We're going to look at the docs, but yeah. So like essentially we're going to add a target called Java binary. So it's going to start Java underscore binary. Maybe then we're going to pass in the attributes. The attributes are like kind of like the public methods. So look up the docs for like.
Might have had a different thing.
You found the wrong reason.
So then we have to like
the name.
We have to pass in. So yeah, these are the attributes.
Fair ones.
Specify, or the attributes that they define for that rule. So we have.
Which goes down to 10 minutes if you're running.
Sources required, the dependencies. All right.
Yeah, so then we're gonna pass in those. So like, we're adding one called
Hello Bazel Bootcamp.
Yeah, Hello Bazel Bootcamp. So.
We have quotes.
Message version of the one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
This one says it requires me.
Sources, I imagine. Java binary.
Just did you.
Is there like a
digital version?
Okay. Sources probably.
Yeah. So it looks like
version.
All right. So for the Hello Bazel Bootcamp.
I think there's a file.
I guess the version. It's gonna be that one. Yeah.
Well,
copy that in.
Yeah.
Type that.
Oh, there we go.
On the separated.
Delete.
I think.
Okay, thanks.
We can check that.
I think we're using any recently added features.
Okay.
Sources generating.
So, yeah, I think like when we go up, I think there's like, they're just telling you how to use this rule. So, this is like one of the Bazel default. Mm-hmm. So what does it say? Like, don't do this. Okay, yeah. So it says don't do. Generate a Java file that Java. Instead, do generating rule.
So not the exact file.
So
that looked like specifically for generated files. So I think that's probably correct. Like, we want to find the source of that hello Bazel Bootcamp.java, and then it should be a string probably. And
No, it works for me.
The colon is like where it is. Oh, where it is in the directory. Like, let's try and run it and see what happens.
No.
We'll get some errors and then. But yeah, this is like
for
that.
Sure, this is.
So how long have you been working with Bazel?
A couple of months. I haven't really done it.
I just, the question I'm trying to ask.
Yeah.
I definitely
okay.
Have a JRE.
Yeah.
Is the JRE package, or is it, I know I have a system JRE, but I was like wondering, is there a way, are you setting up a tool chain for Java?
So I don't fully know the answer to that,
okay.
But Bazel has like, might just be something for Java.
And that's weird.
It's, do you know, is it actually going to download a toolchain for Java? Or
well, it's there's lots of different Javas going on. It will download a toolchain, but unless you pass the right flags, you will also need a Java.
Okay, all right, that's good to know. All right.
But like, it still works if you don't have any toolchain system, right?
I've seen it.
Not by default.
Yeah.
It will expect you to. It will compile the Java with the one that it downloads, and then it will try to run it with the system one.
I see. What flag is that?
You really like that green?
Difficulties. Give me one.
Yeah, interesting. Yeah, how did they suggest doing it?
ID.
You need to pass like dot Java tool chain.
I'll let you kind of play around.
Remote JDK 11 or something.
Okay, I'll look that up. It is working for me. I just know that. I think
totally bash using text editor all the time.
For some reason, I get the external maven error for gray.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
No, do you not have Java?
I ran up some deficit somewhere.
Well, I need
maybe. To. I don't know.
Yeah. It looks like it's trying to.
Do I need to install Java first?
I think you do.
Okay.
If you go to like the Bazel build install instructions, it should give you a layer to like a
JRE. I see.
That's what my plan was to.
Okay, cool.
Let's try this one second. Can you test this, Kyle?
Hello.
I think I have a Java. Maybe it just passes wrong. So I have open JDK.
What if you, I just sent you a, I want to add this flag and see.
This one's literally just.
Where should we solve it?
You know, taking a while. Just don't have go with
it. I have to do that.
Go.
Maybe that's.
Internship.
Try going to another site. I like to go to example.com.
This mascot's really derpy.
It's not easy derpy. It's amazing. So
I think the issue is if you can
watch
a site that's traditional,
you don't have to
download it. It's like, it's really just got anybody to draw it. Right? Yeah, what is that?
Precious is just like go.
But
with go for it.
Like,
they get a little,
if you just
like,
also, like send it. Kind of the last, like you did, I think the run command, right? What was the previous?
That's the point.
Run.
Yeah, do that. But what if you do. That
plug.
List
of bad options.
Yeah, I just want to see if.
Okay,
that's. And then let's change the build to run. I want to see it.
Okay. Let me see if my Java.
Download, thank you.
Which Java do I have? I have a Java 18, so probably not a Java 11.
go.
That actually tells it to do like.
Download runtime.
If we change that word to run, what happens? I typed something there.
Got it.
What, there was something else it says.
Yes, we touch on this because of what happened. This as our office. I'll take that.
No, you have.
I just went through and reinstalled it again.
I think.
We should destroy it.
Oh, I have a.
So the problem is that we have to build.
One day we'll have a liable.
Yeah, why not? Yep.
So you don't even have. Only I didn't even have Jerry.
So I think I have a JDK there.
Does that exist?
So that's why I want to double check what is my Java.
Imagine what we could do with 500 engineers.
Oh, right, like.
Maybe the hybrid is 100.
Maybe the hybrid over 200.
Terminal.
Crazy.
Not hybrid.
Terminal.
So I have a Java here.
No, they can play.
I just.
Exec, well, opt, homebrew, opt, open JDK, open JDK to bless.
Yeah.
Just like one person. That path, one full path, because.
Any ideas?
You see, it's.
Rebuild. Just went dang.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's awesome.
Yeah,
and literally.
Oh, God. My laptop, what am I going to do?
Consider how fast. Computer. Miro.
It's probably my fault, honestly.
Only.
Kind of interesting.
Oh, I need to add them.
Kind of Miro.
Backpack.
I know what? So I was at a.
Wait, you see, I don't.
Cradle conference.
Tenth of week.
I was going back home. My water bottle spilled a little. Like a little bit of water in my bag. And I was like, oh, okay. But it still worked. Worked all week last week.
No,
you were going to take 100 seconds. It's finally gone to you.
I think that was it. Like, I thought I was in the clear.
That's fine.
Like, totally fine. I worked last week, and then now it's like.
Inside of content.
I think
it was.
Yeah, maybe some residual.
And inside of
content. It was completely fine.
You just have to import those.
So, I think that's what did it, though.
It's the job.
Sorry for your loss.
Thanks.
That's what it
did. Well.
They have a
home. I didn't delete anything.
Thank you very much. I just called about AppFolio.
This is
Bill had been. How you been there?
3 years.
Yeah, there you go.
Wow,
so it's
cool.
All.
Yeah, how about you?
I guess I did
more.
Cool.
You may need. I mean, I don't think I need it.
Oh,
no.
Oh, nice.
It's home. Yeah,
it's
so it's
home.
Slash home.
Yeah, it's a slash home.
At least it was out.
So we're good.
Yeah.
I don't want to know.
Yeah.
All right, let's see.
It's home, right?
Yep. Exactly. And then you're going to need to restart your shell.
Every notification.
So now I want to edit this little here, but I'm still kind of.
Yeah, it's a brew. Yeah, you do like which brew?
And then it works.
Yeah,
you do anything. Brew not found.
Oh,
yeah.
See, there's a
there. That's not good.
That I did.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting.
Connection reset by peer.
On here. Maybe your environment is weird, or like your path is missing some stuff.
I imagine.
Oh, my peer.
I didn't do anything. No. How did you install homebrew?
Well, that may just be a dummy
right
file, which.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, let's try this again.
I think this is the same issue.
Okay, checking.
Stack is dealing with right now.
Okay.
The Java.
Homebrew, in brew.
Process. I installed. I think it's wrong. Thank you, Max.
Okay. This is. Yeah. I really wish we didn't have to rely on our JDK inside of brands.
Cool.
A little second.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Cool. So it says, there we go. So then run these commands in your terminal to add it to your path.
Yeah, so that's
interesting.
Because
so I think
go back
in a weird way.
So you see the resources?
Yeah, go ahead.
And then now if you, which.
What you've listed the rule as a dependency of itself.
It works, but I think these commands, I think homebrew is like a kind of.
The source is a Java file, right?
Might need actually in your Z shell or something so that it runs on every terminal.
Interesting.
I would copy those in. Just copy those three commands.
Oh, you do have.
And then I would throw them. Yeah, see, it says.
It's.
So it's putting in your Z profile.
Yeah, instead of my.
Oh, yeah. And I think that should work, but.
Are you in L?
With essential.
Yeah, I mean, so like, what did you, your Z profile, you might have that twice.
You can solve it, yeah. I'm trying to tell this guy in stack, like.
It's like tail. Tail.
Life is what's up.
Yeah.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Oh, you want to.
Yeah, I mean, it's right there. And it looks like it's there twice now.
Nice.
So like, definitely did it before, but like maybe it wasn't sourced or something. Probably.
I used from.
Or like, who knows really, but yeah, now you should be able to do brew.
It's just.
But yeah, you shouldn't need two of them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Edit that.
It was.
It already installed.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably two more. Like. All right. So now if you run Bazel.
I got very upset when I. Because I didn't. Because I put.
All right. So yeah. All right. Let's open up our.
Got it.
Yeah, I think.
Right, good question.
Luckily, I had Jared.
Those are one of the rules.
Not.
You didn't have
to. We still had to.
What was the full?
Keller.
Guys go north.
It's the security reason they don't allow me.
Mechanism.
The command.
Grandfather.
All right, cool.
Yeah, sorry.
Now we're gonna do.
To move all the.
That sounds.
Bazel core doesn't.
No, I think they gave you the build command that we want to open.
Run it here.
So Bazel run Java source main Java Bazel bootcamp colon. So you do need the whole.
Can you just send me your.
Here's another thing. Was the train is super janky.
Really lazy and just like to scroll up here. Percy, can you send.
I know where he is.
I think we're in the range here.
Okay.
I'm out.
Yeah, just copy those two on. Yeah, just send me the thing.
Well, right now we're in terminal, right? So let's.
First, same out time to the
source profile and then to the path of your
whichever train came
tilde. It's in your tilde slash. Yeah, if that's a real file.
Jazz.
And then now try Bazel run.
Don't know why they recommend taking the iterate.
Boom.
There we go. Nice. Thank you for playing IT. I appreciate it.
Oh, no worries. I teach a command line thing.
Everyone who's gotten
the command line in
hello
that class.
Out.
That's super
raise
useful.
Your hand.
Yeah, do you know what source does?
The first part.
Oh, yeah, the first part.
What it does is that it will take the, it will run the file that you specify.
Low expectations.
So if you feel much like those commands profile, what they're doing is they're exporting like
fine for me.
Yeah. So this shell session that we had had
never heard of this concept.
It was
sort of green.
The I come from had the commands they were
the holy world
but loaded
the holy world
into this shell session.
You know, like
this code.
So why is it not doing that automatically?
No.
Okay.
It's because it's like this thing we didn't do it. And this might not. I don't know what it's using under the hood.
It's
Z shell, but it could have been using a different profile. Or it could have been really a number of reasons. Or it could be that we didn't restart the terminal. Like maybe if you create a new terminal now, it will pick it up.
Okay.
And we could try that and see if it works. Yeah. It's probably gonna fail.
That doesn't make any sense. Optimism here. We gotta hope.
There's no optimism in this.
It's not, yeah. Looking already. It's been 10 minutes.
Cool, yeah. All right, lots of stuff to build.
Tell me what you. I'm gonna take a.
No.
It's truly, truly tragic.
Yeah.
Okay. What's David? Are you from New York?
No, I live in San Diego.
Okay, so you are without computer.
Ready to go for him?
I got a tablet.
Yeah,
I might buy something at Best Buy or something.
No, no.
Grab something to work on. Yeah. Yeah, I guess that's what it is. What it is. Yeah.
Never had to build Java myself.
Yeah.
I'm trying. With plenty of Java. I just.
Are you local?
Yeah. I live like Maven.
I can only share tabs.
I haven't been to New York.
Ever?
Very often.
Okay.
Like, I think the last time I thought it was like.
It's Peterson. Is that who you were referring to?
I'm in the area.
Yeah, that's the Maven you were referring to?
Yeah.
My opinion.
Are you originally from?
No, I'm from, well, I'm from upstate. So
okay.
Like,
damn.
Different.
Yeah, I don't.
Yeah, cool.
Like,
cool.
I grew up in Cornfield, so.
A little bit nice.
I can't show my.
Okay, so.
You're like.
Your PC is
nice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
I really set a new graph.
Where was your
your PC? Oh, hey, looks like it worked.
Oh. All right, cool. Yeah, we're good then. What's next?
The hater.
Go server. Is this like following the readme?
I that was my plan.
Okay, yeah, cool. So, okay, so what happened, right? So, like, happens if we run Bazel run again?
Oh,
like, the same command, right? Like, it shouldn't do anything, right?
Because it's already built, yeah.
Right, so it's already built. So, like, it's, I guess,
the beauty of Bazel. Yeah, you change a line, then it'll.
Yeah.
The code build cost me.
Why does it help?
Bazel run gazelle with Bazel run.
It's still wild that Sojo does
run gazelle with Bazel
only works. I guess a real reason is I'm wasting some.
Yesterday I was trying to get it before I leave. Because you have to do this.
So you have like in order, it's like the protocol. Java proto.
I think I'm like point.
Java gRPC.
What do you need to do?
I guess so.
I just wanted to know. Are those like the answers?
Folks conferences are like
you like have
that one. I have longer time.
Yeah. No, this is.
And I originally I was just.
Yeah. I feel like very chill. There's not very many people. So okay. I mean, there's like
usually
maybe. Then I went to last week.
It appears that
there's probably about 400.
Well, like,
and the whole. Center or
Chromium.
It was
like, if I try to share my.
I would say that's a certain box too.
Really?
Because it's very niche. It's like kind of.
I can share the
code productivity.
Yeah,
that's what I was
saying.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's probably because they didn't have a lot of room. So I imagine there could have been like another like 400 people like here at least.
Probably.
Yeah. I mean, this is.
I have everything.
Yeah. Yeah, but this is, I think tomorrow's going to be a little bit more representative, but it's also,
I guess.
Like, still an insane subject.
What am I running next?
I wonder the actual process
of the build.
Maybe.
Step two.
Because I can share everything with.
All right.
First, not useful. I don't know how to plug it into.
Dimension teaching. Slides for that or anything?
Sorry.
It's not guaranteed.
Sorry.
Oh, no worries.
Yeah.
Yeah, stop indicating. I do. So it's actually thing where it's like just the basic.
Well, so promising.
This one's not plugged into anything.
And you have slides. I make people to act. Unplugged. I don't think I could share them. But I can like go through them with you.
Make sure they're plugging back in.
You're obviously here for that.
Yeah.
If you can't share.
You a voice guy? No trends.
Command. I mean.
Yeah, it's particularly
like gets me through, but. Any resources you could recommend?
Walk you through this.
Sure. Yeah. So like the class I teach is like it's basically like 20 minutes of commands and the rest.
I absolutely did be
my company.
Okay.
So it's not a whole lot of content, but a couple slides just like talking about kind of basic stuff like math.
Secret.
I already got like half the class just from like
perfect source of math.
Yeah.
There's the proto.
One warning that I'll do it
right now.
Bazel.
Java Proto Library.
Lots of gibberish.
They allow you to.
Longer. One warning, it's probably fine, we can ignore that.
I love how that's just like common conception for software, it's like, oh, warning, who cares?
We're getting everything.
Listening on port, okay.
Okay, so we have the server, and load it up.
All right.
Yeah, that's it, we're good.
All right.
Default server won't get along each other, curl each. Okay.
Yeah, we're.
Like all the learnings are.
Right.
So. Interprets are.
That's good because they manage.
Yeah, so it must have created a file somewhere, so we.
So it'd be in your go? Oh, or go, okay.
Yeah, go, command server, so like, let's see what it generates. I think it did the. So from the go file, it generated this library rule.
Copy it and change all that.
Automatically has stuff in there.
Oh, I'm sorry, you need to.
Bring your laptop?
Java. Okay, that's what happened, it just.
The Java toolchain.
Looked at literally all of this. Right, and then it came up with the build file for it.
Yeah, yeah, imagine like these dependencies were included as like imports in the Go file, which is.
Well, I didn't put it in.
Yeah, like if we look at now, some imports. Yeah, so it's like import, Google Play, Protobuf, gRPC, Logger. So probably Gazelle probably parsed these, I'm just guessing, we can like back to.
Familiar with Windows, but let's.
File again.
So you said it's in your path, can we just double check that?
Yeah, gRPC and.
Java dashboard.
That's kind of interesting, I don't know how it knows, like with, if these.
And.
Dependencies here, like reflection, I didn't see that in server.go, but. I'm gonna like go to this.
Okay.
GitHub.
Yeah, I was also looking at it in the path.
You're loaded to make that.
I'd never heard of this. Right, I'm also curious.
That's because you name.
How they did it.
I'll get.
Okay.
Things have to specify.
Our shell, I'm still trying to figure that out, like, cause my whole. I tried getting like a VM with. Like getting built this and like.
Oh, yeah.
I do, so like having an automatic.
I have to.
Sick.
Yeah, yeah, you guys already have a build system set up, where it's like, are you always. So.
Yeah, we're like just converting from Scott to Bazel.
That's what?
Scott.
Scott, I remember that.
All right.
Having lost the front end, let's see. What's this?
I don't even know. Condescended.
We have another hour and a half.
Oh.
All right. So everyone, if you didn't get the hello world, this is what I ended up writing in my build file. That to purchase.
Oh. Oh, okay, we're ahead of the game.
Yeah.
Gosh, that one here, technical difficulty. Are you able to figure it out?
I was overcomplicating. Yes.
That's Bazel for you.
Yeah.
That's the natural Bazel experience.
No, I missed it.
Java liberal.
I know what to do.
Yeah. Not knowing what to do and overcomplicating everything.
So nice, man. Thanks for.
Thanks for effort to build.
Okay.
Copy paste.
Still working?
Issue is. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh my gosh, that's what I was.
I don't exactly have the attention span to read.
Oh no. And yeah, we can keep.
You
want to
keep.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure.
Edit the build file for logger.proto.
Cool. So we have proto slash logger and then.
Go. Java proto library. Oh, just the same setup.
All right, I'm gonna.
So nice.
Yeah, all right, here we go. Java client. Edit the build file for Logger Proto. Okay. What are we trying to do?
Edit it.
Yeah, what do we. What is the goal here? Send messages from the client to the server and. Edit the build file.
SQL.
Yeah, there's like, what is?
It's probably those.
What are we? Oh, this it says to do's.
I don't think this is to do Denmark change to GitHub Denmark of to do Denmark. That doesn't feel like that's talking to us.
Oh, this is a logger proto?
Log message returns. So probably return instead of empty.
Expected value.
Add a string in it.
Edit the build file. So we want to edit the build file. So it says, okay, there's nothing here.
So that could be our.
So they're loading stuff. I mean, what is the Java client?
Yes. And then.
Edit the build file for logger proto.
It's package.
Oh wait, edit the build file for logger proto. My bad.
True. So this is the.
Okay. So then we go like here to that build.
Thank you.
Are you sure that you were looking at
that? I'm hearing lots of murmuring about.
I mean, it says edit the build file for logger.proto. I'm in proto logger build.
Let me check on that in a minute.
Mine has more logger.
Oh, really?
Like what?
Oh, maybe that's because of the build.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, that's interesting. So I went. This got modified when we did the.
Yeah, because this all looks.
I kept going a bit. Yeah.
Add it.
Okay, cool.
And then the loader files.
Cool.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so, all right. Already can keep up.
So this error means.
Conceptual. So.
One of the depths.
What is it?
And then edit the build file for
RPC log. So
edit it.
Yeah. Okay. You type in the terminal like
logger pro Java dot proto. Maybe we can add a dependency in or something.
Okay. Yeah. That's good.
Proto. Go proto library.
That needs to be a library.
Proto library. Name logger proto.
Nice.
Right. Done.
I don't want to buy a
I guess that.
Really? Wait.
And there's also, if you do Java C.
So it's saying Java Proto and then Java gRPC.
All right.
What happens when we build a target? Try to that build file. We have.
Can you run?
Have
one more
the new targets right? Logger Proto, Logger Go Proto, and the README was saying we wanted to add Java gRPC. Library, there isn't one in here. So I'm guessing that what we want to do is we
go to the Java gRPC.
We want to do something
Java package.
With Java gRPC.
Says, there you go, option Java package equals Java.
I'll just try to build and see what happens.
With an H.
It works?
Yep.
Almost.
W-H.
Bazel developers can use those. Okay.
That's basically wrong. Wrong Java. So,
I'm going to add in a load statement here.
Nowhere.
You could do something like this.
Scroll down a bit. I think if you type env, what
can add a dependency for Java gRPC library?
I like the way
that's and
so in this case, I was missing. Where is our gRPC target? For an error type.
All right, so
say if you run our tutorial.
Yes, and this
automatically.
I think we need to put
this
in
our
library. Even though, let's see.
Yes, where is it? So I think we need to figure out
informational slides.
So like maybe the
hitting the process. I'm not sure where saying the system cannot find the file specified.
So it could also be
the idea once we go to like native.
It could also be this jar file. So that would be another thing to check whether that exists.
Oh, I think I see that you missed.
So there's this Dutch jar, like C colon, and like
I wonder if you.
Oh, is this part of the Bazel?
So if you go back.
Oh, Java client. It's like measured. Yeah, it's maintained. But it lets you. Looks a little. I think this is getting
type unset.
Yeah, yeah. Add dependencies. Add.
And then John,
I don't know what's going on there.
Okay.
Apps and the underscore.
Add the instructions. Add the build file for the other proto. Add in Java.
Like,
yeah.
Towards the bottom page for documentation.
All right.
So with Java proto library.
Okay.
We're gonna copy like that. We're gonna add that into the build. And we're gonna change the target somehow, which is the only thing we need to figure out. Proto.
Now it's kind of cool. Yeah, I was signing proto in it.
Okay, it's kind of a thing. Is there logger proto would work?
I guess. Yeah, so I guess what we're trying to do
make
is
a Java GRC a logger.proto.
Yeah, I think so.
There's build. Yeah. Maybe you can get it in there.
Logger underscore proto.
Oh, it's me.
Okay. All right.
Oh, maybe.
Go so Java.
Oh, maybe it has to have different.
I think, yeah, it's like different trying to do it.
Like they're directing us directions.
Okay. That's so, like, cool. Okay, I think I kind of think fair.
If we try to build the logger and the client were two separate pieces,
okay.
Build so proto library.
Oh, I
fresh dependencies to add. They were going to make all these various libraries from this one library.
Or you to add what are supposed to be.
Yeah.
So, like, showing the string. Build all. Different files based off that.
I think so. Logger.proto, like what is.
Library. So I had
so the sources
add these two gRPC libraries.
And then the dependencies.
Oh, you added both of these.
Mine is working good.
I don't know.
It's not the code part.
It's
the
run the Java.
The Java gRPC.
I had to add JUnit to that all.
So a little bit about the proto stuff, since a lot of people seem to be in there. There is quite a lot that you have to do in the proto logger file. Although, so in the second step when you were doing the Go things, did have a lot of people reach that?
Yeah.
And Gazelle probably generated a bunch of roles in there, so you don't have to.
I did.
You shouldn't have to touch any of the Go stuff. But you will have to like add these rules for Java, like I have there.
Yeah, so I think we're adding the Java proto library and then the Java RPC. But I think we did that. Did we? Java proto library.
We have the Java gRPC.
Yeah, so I think we need Java proto library as
which
well. So I guess my confusion was that I don't work with the proto file. I guess they're Java based. So we're
gonna.
Yeah.
Well,
I'm kind of confused of how.
So let's.
Wonder what dependencies required for it.
Yes.
Like, this is the auto-generated stuff.
Yes.
I don't
so,
think.
So
I think
yep.
There'll be
like proto.
Just
a library.
Actually, it's probably this one.
I'm trying. Right I'm here. Just trying to understand.
Yeah. So like
that.
I'm actually wait.
All right.
It
needed the gRPC when added.
It's already at the
like, did it already get added?
Yeah. I don't think so. Not
that one.
And
then.
And then.
That's why I'm here. So don't worry about it.
Other Java proto.
Okay. Yes.
Oh. I'm just doing the client.
Oh, you need
it. It might.
The gRPC proto
on its own. If not,
we already defined it. Is this a different one?
Maybe the namespace thing.
I'll do the same.
Yeah, but I do think we're going to need the Java proto library.
Go back to
there's somebody cool.
And then are we loading that rule to Java proto library? So like these are load statements at the top. So
yeah.
Like,
maybe the order does matter. Maybe try putting that
Java library.
Do you have any clue where that would like where we can load that from?
I think if we look at the documentation and
I didn't see it.
Oh, you didn't see it?
No, but
maybe it's like, part of the proto library rules.
The way this is working, it's just like classification.
I've gone through
kind
of that idea.
Cold based on these.
In the front end.
Yeah,
everything builds.
That's why, like, generating the front things.
Okay.
Java for the library. Okay, yeah, so it says.
He's at the following dependency.
Java for the library. So if I had to guess,
I think we have the Java proto library off it.
Longer
category.
Oh, we already do.
Yeah, I added these. Over.
Okay, yeah.
I'm just not sure if we need to load it.
Well, let's try it. So like what we're gonna, so we have dependencies equals logger dot proto.
I think all of their
telling me the dependencies
are the same, like the sources are all their.
Okay, yeah, let's open up another terminal session.
I don't think it should be devs.
Yeah.
What's that X?
Not sure yet. So it looks like kind of the way that they're
game will be defining up there.
Yeah. Yeah. The one that was
gonna look at the
end. Yeah, I guess.
So yeah, oh, he does proto library
building
a proto library. I don't force the blog about products.
Like
it can. And then the one is Java proto library
right? Has the depths.
And then the depths is the target.
Confusing arm
proto. So it looks like
the strength of the target.
For the proto, so we looks like we have a regular proto library.
Java proto, just for the
whatever Java proto library.
I didn't
that's
get
different
it.
From no, just the regular proto library. I don't know.
That's, I'm curious as to why you have to do
the thing. Oh, at everything.
Why do you think you have to do the target, like in Java gRPC library, the sources has the target notation for that?
Let's just see what the proto library does.
Yeah,
because
the proto. Yeah. Logger proto is referencing.
Why? Why?
Like that's why you say. Or sorry, on that first
part of the library,
you're defining
okay.
A target
so,
called logger proto.
Like, okay.
And the sources are logger
generates
proto.
Code.
But in the Java gRPC,
the Bazel
is the generates
proto.
I don't want to spoil it.
Yes.
As
the outputs of that.
Oh.
So rather than we're taking the inputs, we're saying like whatever that is outputting,
okay.
The dependency
the
bin, is
of
that,
course.
That
okay.
Target.
Okay.
So it's like a totally different dependency.
I guess I'm adjusting here.
Yeah. So like, and it looks like that's the order though.
I did change
kind of dark. So there's like.
Do you think it's order specific?
Yeah, mine's running out.
Well, not. I guess when I said order, I meant like the order of the build graph.
Okay.
Like. So like really like it doesn't matter. I don't think it matters which order it is in the.
Oh look, it worked.
We could try it. Like, it might parse
we'll
it and
out,
say like,
yeah.
Hey, that's not defined. But.
All right.
It's okay.
I'm trying
like,
to. I'm so sorry. These are like really
no, it's
which
ones are
linked like,
to
really
what?
Really
yeah,
more
important.
This is a beginner.
Okay, good. So.
Okay. So yeah. So like.
So,
hey,
we need our proto explorer library.
Hey.
Library.
Oh yeah, like we can try building it. So yeah,
that was
Bazel. Does Bazel work here?
The point of the.
GR. Okay, same thing. So yeah.
Well, that's the
so
that
I demand to speak to your manager.
So you're asking as distinct from the Java
sweet.
Proto library?
Yes. Yeah, because
all right, that's another issue.
I'm wondering
cool,
why
yeah.
There's so many different ones.
What?
And
you know what I mean?
Bazel
that makes
the
sense.
Job and
yes.
Job
well, that I mean.
Zero.
The main reason is that. gRPC
so,
is an extension
to
proto
run
buff.
The,
I am not.
Oh, yeah.
So like proto buffs don't really. You know what gRPC is?
A very big
client.
Yeah, it's
test.
It generates some
well,
code which
try to build
like, helps you connect
to
with other, send messages
right?
To others,
yeah.
To other
okay,
to other services.
Yes.
And proto buff basically just knows about. Turning data structures into bytes and bytes into data structures.
Yeah.
And so, like protobuf
right.
At its
like
core doesn't know anything about these the gRPC concepts.
Okay.
And so,
right, so
and so the
proto
Java proto library just generates this proto stuff.
And then
gRPC
whatever the
library
the target is,
knows how to like build on
there
I see.
So we're
Java.
Going to.
Is
so
no
this is like invoking
so
a target when we do Bazel build. So we actually want to
know
match the name of one of our targets.
No, I mean, a lot of the reason it is this way is it's just the way that
and
things
that
develop.
Be
like,
so
it was proto,
we can try
logger
under
gRPC, and that
was like
an extension.
Like logger go
right. But you can totally imagine that someone was like, we're going to make a serialization format, and we're going
to
make an RPC protocol, and they're going to be all like intertwined and stuff.
So it can't find that gRPC Java.
You know, it's
library.
Like this is an architectural decision, but you could go a different way if you wanted. It's not. It's not.
I don't think we need that. Let's comment that out.
Positives and negatives for
coming out the rule that uses it. I have a feeling we're not going to need
the rules in library. The mission
exception. Like those might have been generated.
Cool.
Okay, that's totally unexpected, right?
Yes, I think we have like.
I think I've never seen that, but I don't remember why.
Logger proto not declared.
No, no.
Oh, no, it's.
Take us to one to me.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Sure, any, I'm happy to.
Same name as.
Right.
Completely be outside. I've always wanted to create proto.
I think if I, can I see it?
So maybe we can just not declare that and it will.
I remember.
We could try it, yeah. What happens? I think that might build all the stuff on the logger, but let's try it. I'm not a Bazelite, that's why I'm at the beginner.
Well, the not complete success.
No such target proto logger logger. Okay, so it's saying. Is this the whole error?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, wait, here we go. So it says build 30, name Java gRPC library is not defined. So it says this isn't defined because we're not loading it.
Oh, nice.
Let's.
Newer than that.
I think we do.
Let's try.
I'm going to have to load that.
It might actually be missing.
Probably initially included it up here.
Java gRPC library.
Why just straight?
It said when we did that, is that the right change? Okay, let's try it again. I don't know. Maybe we get a different. It's like kind of hard to read this.
That needs to be Java library.
Error loading package. Unable to find package for gRPC.
That's two separate things. So you have the library, then the test.
Okay.
Are you sure?
Okay, so yeah, it can't find that Java.
Are you sure about?
Let me just like try it.
Yeah, I copied it from.
Oh wait, what about this one right here?
Yeah, we actually skipped up
that. Oh maybe. Yeah, let's try that one. It looks like we kind of included it.
Make it a normal.
It's already there, and then if I run this, I actually will add it. But
things like library test, log client test.
It says each
I'll day out of here. The reason I did it the way I did it is because if you look at the documentation, you have the library target and the test target.
It's loading.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever. I don't think that is enough. Like,
no, you're
an old
rank.
It's not a gRPC library.
So, yeah. So we need the depth.
Oh, that's
the main Java proto. Yeah, okay.
Script test. You know how I love my bash scripts.
Okay.
What'd you name the test? The library's already got.
So then that's defining dependency on this target.
Have all that because they just put it open.
So we define this Java proto library company target with the name text stuff. Now Java gRPC library depends on that.
Oh. Well, spec is because that's a play for
yes.
That's how they're connected.
We just wired it together.
Okay.
So name, yeah, dependency maps to that name right there. So now we're kind of like going back down like the graph. Like it looks like kind of what we have. I'm just reading this. It's like we have the Java gRPC.
I mean, I'm still struggling.
Library, right? One.
If you insist.
And that depends on the
test. Okay, so for this one, depends on the logger Java proto. That depends on
the same. It's the same. Yep.
All right, this go on.
All right, let's do this. Then we have library, which isn't on anything yet.
Actually, it's a top secret data. The phone's gonna have to stay here, guys. It's cool.
I'll end you actually.
Watch, I'm trying.
Somewhere in the rule set, in the magic, I guess, or in the rule.
Okay, what is your Java test
definition?
Okay.
Yeah.
Find the.
What?
It's like an inquisitive corner.
Copy and paste it and push go.
Okay. Yeah, so I played around a little bit with that.
That one's just to spray the head.
Actually, trying to experiment with typing a Ruby.
It says to send messages from the client, which is the client.
Kind of tricky.
Why does that work?
It doesn't the open source Bazel Ruby, Rose Ruby are not
the Java directory thing.
Okay, so this is a mistake.
Yeah.
Made.
Yeah, but like
we've abandoned at this point.
I've closed the panels
in a year, so it's interesting.
I feel like retype messages in here or like
custom rules.
Or,
so I
think there's meant to.
I talked with Alex Eagle when I said that.
Yeah. I'm but you're
like, so how do you like need to? So anyway,
to be a server.
How do you even read this?
Well, that's a very Google.
You ran?
But you didn't build it from the ground by yourself.
Oh, I see it. So it's like.
Anyway, I have no idea. What's
in like Bazel.
Yeah, this is.
I see it.
Yeah.
Like I didn't.
Yeah, I see it.
Advanced sharks swimming under the.
I'm getting
Tyler errors on those.
Under the seas here. But,
I think it could be helpful. I have like no. Background knowledge with like.
Yeah. Okay.
Or like what's
just
going on. Like, okay. Just like seeing like a visual of like a tendency graph that we're.
Cool.
To C++
see what
can solve. I think we have some diagram or something.
Anyway, yeah. Hey.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. Did we like copy the code up there? And
basically, maybe
missed so. Java proto library. So this one's interesting. So it says like docker.proto. For the dependency instead of underscore proto. So we're actually saying that is a source dependency, not.
I just dropped in.
That might actually not be the right thing there.
Yeah.
Just based on kind of reading this thing.
So I think we need to upgrade.
Let's try that again. See if it's.
No,
it should be good. Like,
yeah,
as long as there's no like hard dependency.
Whether we try to
okay.
So it's only finding one target though.
Yeah.
You think that's concerning?
So what do we build? We're doing Bazel build proto slash logger. We try to specify the target. And I think we want to build the last one in there too. Java GR repository.
Okay.
Just a guess. I don't know which one actually does the thing.
it should be possible to build any of those. The kind of the magic is that you're gonna you don't have your source.
Can you build
Java code?
Login.
No, you also don't have.
Oh, I see. Okay, so this doesn't.
Also, you don't have your.
What is like the output of these things? Like, are we like building?
Okay.
Well, I'm not familiar with like proto.
Yeah,
proto
so protobuf,
similar.
Or sorry, gRPC.
Well, we did. This actually applies to
my life.
They generate a bunch of code, and then you write code accurately on the generated code.
Okay.
So the Java proto library and the Java gRPC library basically emit a bunch of code.
Okay.
And then it makes a thing that you can depend on in other Java code.
Oh, okay. So that's why we're editing the build file for the Java logging client.
What's the name?
And so that's those files are right by the where the hello world example was. So that's the handwritten code that you write on top of these generated code.
Get it passed.
You
name your test.
Just
we're writing handwritten code.
You're not writing anything, but there's a something called Java logging client library and mm-hmm. Java logging
at the library. Then you
linking up to the file. But somehow there's a dependency on the output of this RPC library target.
Yes. They depend on the code. These guys depend on the code that these
are doing the library.
Proto library rules
generated. Okay, cool. All right, so then. We aren't able to run that Java gRPC library. Let's target Java. Is this syntax right?
Well, I think you
need
to put another logger underscore there.
Okay.
Library check.
Because
logger Java gRPC proto. Yeah.
Test library.
I think.
Okay. Let's target slash proto slash logger. Are we abusing the syntax here? I just kind of.
Oh.
If that's the correct build.
It's called proto at the end rather than.
I think you're.
Oh, okay.
The thing, if you get close enough, Bazel will print things that are near Levenstein distance. But obviously, if you exchange words, it's a little difficult.
Okay.
I'll just change that to
E.
Getting there.
says, in sources attribute, source file logger.proto is misplaced here. Since this role was created by the macro Java JavaScript library, the error might
have two tests. We have the client test.
Okay, so it's.
You are right.
So we actually have a logger.proto in this Java.
Yeah,
so I think we're actually.
Oh.
So the source is actually the bool. Sorry, the target. The target.
Proto library, yes.
Like whatever this is outputting. Like when
okay.
this is built, we want the
that
out to be the source.
That makes sense.
Yeah, that could be Java
JavaScript. So sources can be either. Targets
and then
or files, I guess.
This is the
but depending on the definition of the rule.
Well,
is that right?
Target is the processing. So, every file, every source file in the package is a target.
Mm-hmm.
And then every rule, which has a name, is also a target.
Okay. I don't get like.
Okay, I'm now confused. Names, they can live in the same namespace.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just built this one.
I'm able to say, oh,
wait, no.
Okay, is this missed with some compiler?
Hey,
there we go.
Looks
okay.
Like we did something.
I have all the chain connected correctly there.
Yep, exactly. So we kind of built like this chain where we have like.
Okay,
so that might.
Like, you know, these depend on
you might be able
each other. So you have the Java gRPC library, the Java. Proto library and then the proto library kind of depending on each other.
Got it.
And so like the outputs are kind of down.
That makes sense.
Curious. So I ran the integration test and we're saying and not found for
okay. successfully.
And
cool.
So you can see that it said I generated a jar file full of source files.
Nice.
And so that's the like what the output is.
Cool. Cool, yeah. So I guess
test source.
I think we really care about what's in there.
Right.
Because yeah, so like we ran these rules that do something useful for us. Those are the useful things. Now we're going to depend on
we'll start to test
targets in some other place because we need those outputs that got generated by the rule. And like these rules under the hood, they could do anything.
To see where you
test
code is.
The Datadog built make it easy for us.
Well, that's what
actually
one of the initial statements was.
So
we need to know one part of Bazel
or
you take care of the rest.
So, yeah, writing rules is very different than like just like
source code is exactly dependent.
Yeah,
it's like a totally different kind of.
Oh, so he does
permission denied.
Okay, cool. So then the next thing is we're going.
Edit
the build file for Java logging client.
So it knows it's
library in Java.
So
you're gonna go to that place.
I think what you're posting there is a when I was missing the Java proto
along client.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So that's build file
including as a
Java logging.
Right.
Client.
Yeah. So it tries.
Imagine we're adding
varies language.
Java binary. So it says
doesn't want to
one
trends of
Java library
because then you would
Java login
like wasting
library.java.
Wow. Wasting
yeah.
You would have excess dependencies.
Oh, wow.
You,
okay. So
you have a really big dependency tree. You only want to
binary. It's already built.
Exact.
I think we want Java library.
Like
at least
like
what the
Java
Java underscore library. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna say like well what we want to do is we want to build
yes.
login client library. Java.
Eight.
So
I can't run this.
Literally,
some uncertain
branch. We can name it whatever we want. Like,
yes.
It actually just doesn't matter what you
and
do. So like the names are like user defined.
Keep
like hey, like I'm creating.
Yeah,
creating a
thing.
Yeah, and that's just what
to build on.
And that's what you refer to.
Exactly. Yeah. So this could be anything. It'd be like.
And I run it. I run the.
I'm gonna stick with Java logging client.
Yeah.
Again. It should
whatever it says okay to
I'm not sure how to debug
I need to
enter
the
job.
So did you do step 2 in the reboot?
Yes, I did.
So mine is the
library
have been commented out.
Already defined a library for Java.
Right.
Oh, okay.
You just add to that
test.
Oh,
you need a comma.
Oh,
test file.
I see.
Now we're gonna have
library.
I love these.
Got it.
Yeah. I interpret that as a.
30, I think that's a.
That's fine when you run it.
It's a Bazel Java login client.
Yeah, so you need to, give it a very specific name, which is.
Now we.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's the file name.
I think we have a dependent.
Because Bazel.
Absolutely, come on over.
Companies know what your function is. Right, and so.
Yeah, no worries.
So like.
Was fine, but.
Two went fine, three, I copied what they had there, and I don't think, whatever this one was.
So Bazel tries to be.
I think it was.
I feel like you should be getting my output.
Yeah, I'm gonna write it. To add a dependency.
Bazel tries to guess what the name of the.
Yeah, okay.
And so you can see, that's why it's trying to load.
Oh, never mind. I didn't even realize.
See, that's cause.
But it's that, but it's like.
All the one on you.
I think binary.
Library one. Apparently, I learned it has to be the same name, cause.
Yeah, that's the convention. You can all, there's a way you can tell Bazel what the main class is.
Yep.
Why is it not? That is why I'm like. How does it know to start the server?
Oh, just to get home? I mean, this part looks the same.
So, and.
Exeter. So we are on.
They're running the.
Did you?
Well.
Holiday, like how you.
So yeah, okay, because there are different test format outputs. That's where we're at. So enter in the editing your RC file. So edit the build. Our pro documentation. See this project.
Oh, we have 40 minutes. Well,
I'm confused.
Added in. Xcode takes a long time to download.
Yeah,
like gigabytes of files.
Or Cody has up there, but the reason we did that was they flew in IP blankers that actually based off this, we figured we'd want to have a proto target.
But this format makes at least the quality where we're not next realized of testers that we are just going to create the proto library
thing.
And do you know how they connect
our tests versus
I didn't either? So apparently. Can set them a chain.
Makes sense.
Yeah, so have a C chart.
I have.
You can set them a library. Have a chain.
Library.
Output of each other.
Okay.
It's protos that generates using
library.
Based off like.
It was
like that dependency that logger proto.
Why
that means on the output.
Okay.
It's one.
Oh, I got a proto. Once I bring the proto stuff to set my Java library.
My bad.
My Java client built file scripts to log right
now. Yeah,
it's
not
the data, not the
location. So, months ago, sir, then it gets the PL.
Stances.
Yeah.
And it kills.
Yeah, you're welcome. Go for it. We basically just have been like, yeah, they
made
that one add up there.
Did you have to create stability on the target students?
Because I thought, I mean, I didn't understand. Exactly why they're
we are.
You have to change the
thing.
Right?
Yes. Well, there. Everything is a label there. But, this is almost really refers to.
So that was the job.
What you bring here refers to.
So,
refer to.
I'd like to finish
the name in the solution package.
I see.
Which is a job.
Oh, and that's Eleanor. Okay, so it's not completely wrong. And the other needed, and we say, oh, it says here. And then logging client binary, those other two.
Yes, those are
kind of okay.
Other dependencies and other repositories of the code.
Okay, so it wasn't kind of just by like
reading sources.
Okay, so thank you. I was kind of thank you. Those actually, but like he verified that it was like sandbox and
okay. All right, that is probably it.
Okay. We have to have Java put to library and Java in the loop.
Yeah, I think.
Can you explain what gRPC can be put thus far?
Like target.
Yeah, maybe. Sorry.
And I'm going to want to have the
loop. If you're wondering what the hell protobuf is or what gRPC is, I can briefly tell you. Sorry, that's a bit of a. Assumptions that we undoubtedly make.
Yeah, like that.
What the example application here does is that there's a Go server and then there's a Java client that we've written that talks to the Go server. And the way they communicate is not like HTTP or REST or something. It's a RPC protocol called gRPC, which is fairly commonly used in big companies. And gRPC depends on something called protobuf. And protobuf is data structures and turning them into bytes back into data structures. So basically you
I don't know.
The client, server code.
I mean, really, like the important thing.
Object in your programming language.
Java proto library is.
And protobuf turns that into bytes, and then
data dog wrote
the other side.
Do anything, and they're basically like functions.
Thank you,
Bazel. So when we say Java,
what like all these rules that you're writing in the
code, and then we're passing the
build file do they generate
as the name. So now we're defining a target with that, and then the dependency we're depending on the Augur proto a target that we defined defined earlier. So what it outputs, I don't know. We'd have to actually kind of like look at what that rule, like how they wrote
that one. They just said it skipped to the bottom.
I think what it's doing is it's. I mean, it has some outputs that it defines,
like they're
and it has this dependency. So whatever the knows what outputs it creates and what inputs it creates, and I guess it's kind of an abstraction. So like until we actually look at the rule definition, we wouldn't
like
know what
are going to be a bunch
of like what it's actually outputting. I guess it's probably like some source files. It could be what we could do is.
All you can really say about depth.
I don't know. It's really going to be hidden kind of in the rule definition, and I don't know if we have access to that or like.
So
it's creating some files or like some
cases,
and then it
generated these like create jar file
jar
base.
Yes, it's putting.
Oh yeah.
And we're able to connect it by like
jar file. Yeah, it's like launcher script. So that's implementation detail of the proto library. Yes, and I mean
to be honest, I'm not very sure either.
It's pretty different with tests.
We want to connect our Java.
Often used with tests,
and
like test,
and then we want to
like
depend on that.
So
connected it.
Normal. What happens is that all the data, like the entire transit,
that's kind of how we made our like with dependency chain.
It's available to
that target
when it's running.
You
don't necessarily need that information actually
generated.
This is section 3.
I'm not sure what
the color
fine.
Right. So we want to generate Java binary now. So we're going to create one.
I ran the
under Bazel
this is
I control C that.
An executable, right? So like the output of this is finally going to be something that's going to run code. So sources, like we know what the sources are.
And I exited out of this.
Actually,
so it said it.
You don't need npm
or Java.
Java logging client dot Java.
Yeah, so that
our manifest protos.
Man left found is there may be
from the Java.
Maybe a race.
Yeah, it's probably has a dependency on this rule.
Let's
use snake case though. Just
so I get
consistent.
Partially
on the depth we have EngFlow. I think we should. I don't know. What do you think? I don't know.
So I'm not.
I guess it works either way, but it's like a little. It might get confusing if we have like snake case. I guess this is all. Okay, you know what? Fine.
This file has
camel
this
case.
This one. Right,
the dependency is going to be to.
Like the kill will be executed unconditionally, and so
if I as a string.
Already dead.
Then
that's the end of the integration test. I'm trying to kill it. So it's basically it's not like the world's most robust integration test.
So there's a chance that like it tried.
So
unavailable. This is just because it's.
Okay.
Like it seems like up until
okay,
the kill
fine.
Point.
So
generates it generates somewhere, I guess.
You want to open that code? Integration test does like
that. It's definitely
exactly. Oh, yeah.
So Bazel run the whole. I think it.
Host server. Probably.
Yeah, so if the Go server like crashes or something, then this will not.
Well, I think it's something where we need to have them running.
that could have been.
Would be safe.
Right, it did, so it did work.
Yes.
Oh, I mean, we have tests that require services.
Well, no, I mean, isn't that what it's trying to do, though? It's trying to run.
So I'm kind of like.
Maybe the problem is that you were.
Okay.
So it is.
And then it's not in a network namespace.
Yeah.
So when this one started, it just immediately crashed because it couldn't listen.
This one is only the.
And then it was talking to the other one.
So basically it'll.
Log. Oh, yeah, but. Oh, yeah, no, I think it was.
So I think might not even.
I think that's.
We do slash slash.
Then 7 years.
I think it's an empty line.
I have a feeling that actually works. Slash slash colon, then the name of the target that we define.
So.
It means that it.
Yeah, people got the client test.
Okay.
This thing doesn't work.
Oh, it says no such target.
Understand.
Java log binary.
Ago. Use the wrong.
Yeah, maybe if without the double slashes, can we try that really quick?
Sure.
I feel like there's a way to get this to work without typing the whole thing.
And a library and this binary.
I don't know.
Let's try it.
So the Java.
What is the?
Oh, I know what that is.
Target. It's the same thing.
Yeah.
It's like it's going to that default build.
Oh, you do. Okay, yeah. So I guess we do have to pass in Java source.
Or at least probably like.
Or CD into that directory.
Yeah. A little bit different for every like library is like really create a jar.
Just roll with it.
They have like a big tree of Java.
Okay. Well, this is at least
Java binary.
Why is it not giving this so far?
But additionally, it has like
the
main
Bazel.
Class.
Ah.
And then like the test.
Bazel run,
like,
yeah.
Depend on the same.
Oh,
okay. Yeah. So that's what happened binary, here, right? So keep going up. I think the errors are usually at the top.
That's
says
found one
error. Java failed as
which
command.
One
the log error package io.grpc does not exist.
What?
Or io.grpc.
So for the test.
One thing,
need
one thing that's weird here.
Binaries?
Yeah, we probably do
so
need this.
A Java test.
That says
on Java libraries. A Java test
io.grpc.
Java binary.
It looks managed test. Channel.
So, like
so
any code
I don't know where managed channel.
Core.
You can depend
you try
on
core.
Should
yeah.
Be in a Java library.
Like,
oh, wait.
So we want to
wisely just like forget the Java library and just define a Java binary Java test, but have to list like all of this.
Oh, I see.
The Java library can just hold the common stuff.
Okay, so,
so usually
like,
there's
like
a comma.
Yeah.
So like when we load
Java
or
library,
we need
like
something else.
Nice little.
Maybe it's in the instructions.
That one. Pro
it's kind of like
so
packaging stuff.
Yeah.
Use it in an easier way.
Sure.
No.
It's like
a
common.
It actually says it's
a
dependency.
Like
I don't know.
You can use it in a car or a bicycle
okay.
or something.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's just saying it's a dependency.
No,
so maybe that's a dependency
the
on the.
Sure, sure.
And
that's why we're here. Happy to answer any questions.
Java. So we haven't.
And now,
we're doing lib java log client lib.
Java binary that you wrote. Is it the original one?
What?
Is it
Java logging client library? So we're.
No, the login
so
package IO GRPC does not exist.
Yeah.
So maybe this is actually
so,
a dependency
so like
on the library target.
And the Go server.
So,
the,
like,
or, sorry,
it says it's a def, right? So, like, when we scroll down.
I didn't even know we had a def.
library.
Happy to.
Maybe we need to depend on that package. It's a dependency. So let's
that makes sense.
Let's throw
yeah,
that in there.
The main ones have
errors.
I was guessing.
complaining about logging.
Hello, Bazel Bootcamp.
My library not existing.
Oh, does it actually?
Let's go.
Yeah, does that define those?
Can you show me the build file?
I think we want this guy, this IO GRPC job. I'm really sure.
Grab my charger back.
No.
Which? Sorry. Is this?
Yes.
It's complaining about this.
When building Java logging.
So I think we literally want this as in our dependency array.
It's gonna lay off.
Oh, you think, oh.
Yes, we want that literal string, so it's actually like a dependence.
Okay. Oh, yeah. This should be.
So we do need some more.
Like going back and forth.
I guess.
I read it through.
Yeah, so we don't think we need Bazel Bootcamp, because that didn't really do anything. It was all a little. We are including.
Trying to figure out what tests.
Packages of dependencies for the build.
Same thing. So.
Yeah, we need the comma, good call.
And then now what happens if we build a wave? We're missing a comma at the end of that sources too.
Oh, then.
Four bucks?
Yeah.
Probably could, but.
Right.
Cool, yeah. Of course.
If you don't declare visibility for target.
Let's try that. Nice.
It's a dirt.
Hub is just up to other things in the same.
Oh, no. Close.
Probably need the other dependency.
Well, let's see what the error says.
Private from the rest of the.
And scroll all the way up.
Yes.
All right, here we have the package logger gRPC does not exist. And logger gRPC logger in Java log client library.
So.
Yeah, so that comes from our the target that we built, right? So like this is actually on the gRPC logger that we built in our Java gRPC library target.
Okay. So we're gonna have to add that in.
Yeah, that's another right. So like it's a dependency on the gRPC that we wrote that generates build. That generates those files.
Yeah. 19 is not 17 might.
Like serializing
it. Yes, Google will help.
Ask the internet for help.
And then
that's the way
one's like a fully.
It's not so.
Well, we'll try it. Yeah, we'll try it.
Dependency here.
It says the target does not exist and it's looking at Java source main Java Bazel Bootcamp.
Yeah,
colon,
so
logger.
We have to go to the like, actual path of the.
Right. So here we can add in like the path to that.
So I don't actually remember what the source code looks like for this.
Locker.
Because
it's creating the message also. Just sending it. So.
Exactly. So it refers like this is a type from the gRPC.
Please add the following dependencies.
And then. Here's logger.
Proto logger, logger proto.
You run
Java logger. Okay, it just says please add the following. Okay.
And
or you can use the build dozer command.
Neat. Sounds like why are we.
So I think we can go ahead and add that in.
You can tell.
So that's nice. I think like
yeah,
this, is, this came
cool.
from probably came from the person who wrote the rule, right? So our host like probably put in there like oh like you also need to depend on this.
Can you also use
yeah point. Yeah. So let's go ahead and let's try that.
Starting point.
So it has
okay. So it said please add the following. Let's scroll up again. Let's see what's going on here.
Oh, the expression.
Error using and
what this is trying to say if you can put
error strict using type Bazel
tags
log message from indirect dependency
when you depend will cause Bazel to
instructor or some
only run it once so that's
indirect
that's
strict
there's like
that's what you can do to fix it. Sorry I forgot that
dependencies
yeah.
So like, try deleting it.
I'm gonna try.
There's a target Java log binary field to build. So
I'm gonna break it.
Fantastic.
Java binary.
Got it. Maybe this needs to depend on.
That need a colon actually.
Yes.
You can either request it by the specific.
I don't know if it does or doesn't. Okay. It says thing.
Verbose.
Try that build those thing. It's like copy the whole command. Yeah, from build dozer.
And one of them is.
We need to install build dozer. I don't know if we have that.
I say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting it.
Give it.
Go ahead.
I'm not actually.
Yeah, you pass it to run.
Oh, no, never mind. Please ignore me. Because it wouldn't run.
This. Like, why? I yeah. First of all, I forgot the.
This might depend on.
And I had this dot job.
On the,
Oh, Java yeah, maybe it's maybe what it's saying. Oh, it says Java log client. Yeah, maybe there's more dependencies.
Package.
There we go. Oh, wait.
I am not sure if this is.
Apple's already.
The name on the command line.
Good luck.
Oh, it does
oh.
That.
Well,
we're supposed to pass.
Because
oh,
gave up on this. I
because we say
that's you know, like normal work.
I struggled to read around.
Yeah, so I mean,
add depth.
Like,
overall goal is that you heard about tags.
That was my.
But, but I was just trying to figure out, like,
the. Is it a binary rule?
If I can't find out, I'll let
Java
you
log.
It's really slimy because it's basically just working around the test
graph. I'll take
yeah.
One of the three. Okay, then.
That's in their rule. They add a visibility public.
So it's,
that might be the key there.
And like,
oh,
I don't want to like, do software engineering from this example.
Wait, did you think it's because it's not in here?
I wonder if the test was saying might
just
be.
Just learn to put things in tags.
Bazel config.
I think that's like. That's why we're chained. Okay. We don't have to move the rules.
No,
files.
I don't know if it's global. Baby.
Here's the thing.
I just built it.
Do we have files?
Oh, how many build files? I mean, so far we've edited, I think, two or three. Yeah, three build files so far.
I think what's happening
is they're all in the S scan. Yeah.
In the course.
That correctly.
Only one of the pro right there. Yeah. And that's not the one we're working on right now.
And you already set the build and the proto log.
Yeah, we did. We ran the build in the protolog.
So I put up now
which was
the
this one,
answer to the Java unit test build file part.
Oh, we're falling behind.
That's when the end of I mean.
Yeah. Well, let's try the visibility public thing. I think that's like
what?
Maybe what we just needed.
Maybe. Like
Zach.
Oh, we got that one.
What's the typing?
So default target visibility is
right. Yeah. So,
so like this. So like
overall,
rule targets have
controlled by what the rule is, but there's like very strong convention. So the dependencies are generally things that have to be available at build time. Right. So in order to compile this stuff, compile go, you have to have the like archives of other packages and with the jar files.
All right. Let's give it a shot.
Going to be using the actual build process to do those things. And then data is.
Wait, is that?
Generally, things that.
Same, right? Java log client.
We're going to expect to have available at runtime or at test time.
And then, all right, what's the issue? Still the same thing.
Data in the SSH here because you're. Or SSH test because you're not trying to like make some sort of horrible executable which blinks both the Go server and the Java compiler. You want to use those in your test. And so that it just becomes data. So another like other common thing is like you
yes.
to Bazel Bootcamp Java log client lib. Proto logger.
Proto.
I mean it's right there.
Either way we're writing the target is not correct.
Basically Bazel makes that all available again.
Yeah, what do you mean?
Like just doing this notation.
Oh yeah. So maybe try Yeah.
But it feels like it was getting close to working because it's telling us exactly which one to.
Right, So we could try like Bazel build. Try building it? I don't know, maybe.
Sure.
I think run should build it. If it's not available. Maybe we need to do it from the root directory. I don't know.
Come on.
Ask for help.
I'm not.
Just like a good go.
I seem to have more problems than that.
Help!
From kind of like everything.
Yeah.
Before the test.
The test. All right, so nothing on this laptop.
The base of the run.
Yeah, so we're like getting this.
I'll let you.
Yeah, we're getting this like. had to follow independent.
Yeah, so this is an incorrect error message. You actually need to add.
Yeah, I bet you this is what it's
the Java version of the logger proto, right? So remember, you made two targets. You made the gRPC Java one and the proto one. So this is you're saying I want to depend on like that proto file, which is like I don't know anything about Java.
Got it.
Okay. So it's the logger Java proto.
One. Yeah, logger
proto.
There's still apps in store.
Java.
Some.
Right.
Back to Google.
The one.
Okay.
Yeah, it is on section 5. I think it looks as.
We're having some trouble with the syntax for the statement. Like, we couldn't.
Or
we have to, like, just full thing every time, like /// Java source main Java. Colon.
And I think.
Well, I see you must be in that directory now, right?
Yeah, we're in the directory now, but like, is there a way to reference it in a less verbose when you're not in this?
You can do a relative. So if you don't put the /// then Bazel will think it's starting from the repository. But if
this sort of looks
start with /// then it'll be real.
Oh, okay, cool. So it's already
basically.
Okay. Which is what you're doing with the current syntax.
Number 4. The notes.
It's because it doesn't even have a package, and so Bazel says, "Oh, it's the current package."
No. It doesn't sound like we have to do /// but instead we needed to for the Java library.
A little bit.
For the products we built.
Like, so do you have any
Java
opinions
proto
on building
library?
There's so many.
There's
And we just need to add that one too.
Using
but
like
the
general
message it gives
to make a build system work.
Instead of
really nice.
For proto Java.
I have a lot of custom rules. I mean, it really depends on what you're trying to accomplish and the trade-offs, right? And some public things are much more mature and widely used and generally better.
Lives in Midtown East.
Let me.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Very quickly.
Yeah.
I'm trying to understand why this. At all. So it tells me.
They're the only ones in here. You didn't.
This.
You get it.
All right. Cool. So now we're at the next.
Yeah.
Step.
So I think that needs
so
to be.
So it says.
Oh, you need the other one.
Basically saying that.
Oh, right. So we want to run
95
binary from section 2.
Sounds like I uncommented.
I think it's already running though. In our other terminal.
That's what I thought.
Maybe now.
Yeah, it's already in use. So it's already running. And then we run the Java. We can run the Java binary. Yeah.
Okay.
I mean,
yeah,
it didn't
so
change,
off
right?
The race
yeah, we can like control C.
Cool.
And
cool.
Thanks.
My CD started. I guess
I'll run this.
And then in another terminal or another shell session,
I'm
gonna run the Java binary,
and it finds.
I ran the Java binary.
Oh, you already did.
Thing,
yeah.
Let's do it again.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I guess what my thinking is that like
same thing or
it's still like a middle log or something.
So
or not the big
and that
running
was set on the web page.
Can I
find or load main Java log binary.
It's this is not a test, right? So basically test that means build and test.
Mm-hmm.
So if you give it something that is not a test,
it'll build the Java
binary. I just need to run it.
You need to pass the target, which is a test, and that'll run the test. But Bazel will. Basically, you can do anything with the test command that you can with.
Bazel normally writes all the code.
Yeah, it's completed, and then Bazel
just
run,
has extra features
and then could not find or load main class. Bazel
boots
on the log.
This should be the
log. Is it? I wonder.
Yes, assuming you.
We actually do depend on the
thing.
It's working.
Someone else is seeing that.
I
was just saying hello. Well, that it works with.
Yeah, let's see. So.
Where is it?
Okay.
Yeah, I guess it is. And if you have it as a.
Okay, I'm in the integration test.
Okay.
So, and I'm wondering if I'm even the right. I got the if. Now, obviously, I can see when you run 10.
Yeah, so, it's saying
this temp app.
Bazel Bootcamp.
They're all sharing this.
Not find Bazel Bootcamp Java log binary.
I can see where there's an issue here.
Okay, so did it
put that path?
So that's, yeah, that's because the past, the tests are racing with each other.
Right?
They're all running at the same time.
No, no, I'm running.
But then do I also need to send the test process ID?
There's no
go server and make the IP of the listeners the same as the test.
Not find
right now.
Java log.
Kill.
Oh yeah, so
I'm seeing this every time now.
Yeah, so that, so you shouldn't need to set that.
So do I need to send that in
the build.
Oh, that's in my laptop.
That should be set magically.
Okay, all right, yeah.
Because I haven't actually worked on.
Oh, okay.
That far.
Okay,
you
awesome.
Were doing great.
Run the test.
It's got to be this.
So maybe it's a different
one running in the other.
I see.
Yeah. It doesn't.
Did you get it to work?
Yes.
Oh, we're still having issues.
So, yes, and so I. That's
getting like
maybe
a.
We have the
it looks like you haven't added those.
You're getting this like.
Not files.
So I have to add them.
Yes.
Okay. So I installed the JDK 11.
That's not what I was getting. Did you say again?
Yeah, I could not find our load main class.
I'm wondering
we need .java in
actual.
Oh no, do you have it in a
downloaded?
Are we sending the process
doing something?
Or do we make so if you run on Java version,
maybe oh like is it? I think there's one.
one deal.
Oh, is there another dependency
in the logger? Yeah, in the logger.proto.
Is Java home the environmental variable?
That?
The first line after package default visibility. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, because it wasn't finding what it was.
In the proto class.
Oh, wow.
Proto logger.
Yeah, the very.
It's not
the one. Oh, you did it already. Never mind. I don't know.
Oh, darn.
It's really weird. Do you want to?
It seems like it.
So we have a default divisibility.
I've written very little code, I will admit. But I know how to pass an argument. I hear
I think this is what you're gonna keep hitting that problem. until we get it. So
the port has to be
running the library.
Logging.
Port has to because they have all their
and then the next gen, you need to press another
Java.
Option.
Where you got in those though?
There's
the integration test.
And
so the
source
is the Java file it's depending on.
Yeah.
But this dependency is public.
Do you use the right name for the Java?
505.
Java log client.
Oh, Caleb.
Yes. And so that depends on the output.
It seems.
For piece of Java binary is all
5005.
So actual Java.
Where's last name?
So need to
the original.
I think you need to ask him because.
Yeah.
Okay. Because that is beyond my small level of
understanding. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for trying.
No worries.
Because I got that as a very
you don't have
chip clicker. Yeah,
okay.
Well, HTTP. Yeah, the problem is it's like in between.
I think we've had it.
That's fine. So we need to be able to specify.
If you want to 6 months.
Oh, man.
The gRPC port, that's the one that matters.
This one is, okay, gotcha.
So if you can get the integration to like pick a port, like.
I think, yep, I see. Okay, makes sense.
Okay.
All right, I'll work on that.
Let me double
check. Well, the trick that you're supposed to learn about exclusive.
Exclusive?
The tag.
Oh, I thought I was actually going to get them to run.
Yeah.
Okay.
There we go. I was actually going to run them just like all at the same time. There's no stopping on it.
Well, except the code is bad.
Oh, okay. I'll give it a try. Thank you. Okay.
I have to say, you're learning about a Bazel feature. Which will help you work around poorly written.
Yeah, that's fair. I can see it. That will tell. I'll give that a go first. Yes, makes sense.
Cool.
Okay.
Yeah, so
running the anything.
Right, that makes sense. Or is that is the tags exclusive?
So it'll be like tags
targets.
Exactly right.
Okay.
So tags is the
I guess. Like this will work. Saying that it should have it up relative.
And this is get, lets you pass like an arbitrary list of output is and some of the
I think it's
special meaning.
Okay.
So like for example,
look at
another
integration test
we don't say that build all the targets in my repository.
It is it wants to find a Go server in the Java client,
which is useful for like
you need to make those available to the integration test.
Somebody.
Adding some
okay.
lines to
awesome.
That.
I'll give this a go, and I'll probably
so you need to add
some
server
so I can actually get them all
right.
Yeah.
And then that will make it available to them. All right, we have it again.
Yeah.
So,
wait, yeah, why does it say it completed successfully and then could not find?
Okay, yeah, here's our issue.
Could not find or load main class bazel.bootcamp.java log binary.
Line
caused by class not found exception.
Yeah, there's
okay, so the build was successful,
yes.
But running is
I presume that our test should
like he showed the timeout.
So I'm wondering, do you actually need Java Home?
If it's an absolute, yeah,
I did. See, what's he finding it?
But well, it's weird because
so this is
really, because it's right now that you're getting the right one, right?
Oh, because I feel like this is gonna be something
put in my path. That's why changing the
tags. I added
just clear the errors if you want to set Java Home.
When you run a Java program, you need to tell it name of the main class. And if you don't say that, then it will assume the main class has the same name as the target.
All right, Java login client.
Elegant.
Yeah.
I think we can do source is good. And the depths is still that one.
Yeah.
These two.
No, there.
So, Java login client.
So it's still having
this? Oh, this. it's a Samsung.
Oh, I've seen one like that. That's
yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, it's a Samsung Galaxy S6 Plus, I think. It's got the OLED. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like it. I mainly like it for the OLED. It's really great for like watching like Netflix and stuff.
Yeah, it's a good screen.
It's so
yeah.
Small and light.
Yeah, yeah. It's very thin and, you know, not quite as powerful as like iPads. But,
an improvement.
Media consumption is really great. I really love the display.
I've had a number of Android tablets that have been happening, and that looks nicer.
Yeah, you really have to kind of spend the extra money to like get the good processor and stuff. Otherwise, like it's going to be way underpowered. Yeah.
So it looks like it looks like you have a working here. So there is a.
It's right there.
It's printing both. Also, a server.
They're running
in the Go command server directory.
Done.
Oh, excellent.
There must be something weird about that job installation.
Integration test up next.
So, I have a quick question. This is normal. I run Bazel.
Okay.
Does this look normal?
Okay.
Oh, no,
so, Java client unit test.
Yeah, you have to say what you want to
edit the build
so you have
file
to
for
nice,
Java
yeah.
Login
so
client
the
library
ones
test.
That
that
printing out.
Okay, so we want to run the integration
test.
So, the code is already there. Now we want to run
it. You can say Bazel test.
So it's probably going to
be
under like
everything
slash
below
Java.
The current directory. You can also say Bazel test which will be everything.
Edit the build file for Java login client library test.
There's
a
Java directory.
Right? There's a build thing.
I know what. Thanks, that's cool. That's a useful basic
description and client test.
Yep.
While you're in their building,
yes. Edit the build file from Jack.
Thanks.
Test documentation. So,
is
someone
should
use a mouse?
Is this like a symlink to Java?
Symlink like a mouse.
Like
yeah.
That's good. We could do like EngFlow branded mouse pads. That'll be our next swag.
Yes. Oh, this is fast. Nice.
It looks like it. So I would
just having this
real
binary
A directory.
That
looks like that. It looks like that one.
Source.
Hello, perceive or correct.
I'm so confident.
My God.
That's correct.
I would have stayed on yesterday for like maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Heard, I'm sure that.
Yeah, I know.
But I don't know why, so I should probably.
So.
Yeah, we'll get there.
That hands right.
I literally haven't seen. It's 30 days. I think I have also.
I'm seeing a pattern here.
So on Friday, when I get back, I'm going to do one.
Wait, hold on.
Yeah, so try setting general home.
Tony, hit it while I started.
So it looks like we're missing a colon.
So hey everyone, just it's a quick time check. We have about 5 minutes left and then we're gonna go downstairs for lunch.
Okay,
cool. No. So basically you need to specify in data, you'll need to test both of those. Java,
then we do Bazel.
Ah, yes,
Oh wait, so what it's gonna do is gonna pull both those, put them in test source, and it finds them in that directory.
Probably
the code does need to be there. It'll put all the files in there. Yeah, exactly.
Okay, got it. Java login client library test. Okay.
Test.
Name whatever. I guess they do use the camel page.
This is what my integration test.
We don't have a data imported.
File looks like. And
oh, yeah.
You all might also see that the other step. Shows you that if you run it concurrently, then it fails. But you can stop Bazel from running it concurrently with
this data.
Exclusive tag.
So we actually do
True. And like every other command that runs
is big.
Sandbox.
Okay, so that
sandbox
that gives Bazel a sense of how resource intensive the test is.
Do you think we can?
So it kind of like it
estimates
it. And is it our own estimation? Is it our estimation?
No, I think that
you can say things like, please only run the small tests because I want to get instant feedback about like fast feedback about
data. Okay.
So is it going to avoid doing certain things?
It doesn't really by default, but it's just like another, it's like a piece of metadata that can go in. So you can say on this size broadly, like people,
yes, we're really good.
Like in a continuous integration system, they were going to run a small test first. And then if those fail, we're just going to stop. We will only run the really big resource intensive ones after like some initial testing.
Yeah, you're right.
Periodically.
Okay, so that's cool. So it's
and why is my syntax on?
The exclusive tag tells Bazel that you cannot run that test concurrently with any other test.
Okay.
Oh,
it's because you didn't
want. Okay, that makes sense.
So it basically means the test is bad.
I think it's.
Oh, okay. I see.
I don't know what it is. Because we always want to be able to run everything.
Bart was going to take
parallel.
For the planet.
Java and sources.
Did that change anything?
I uninstalled it. I'm
going to install it. Oh, here. So I was looking at this. We go check this out. And that probably.
I had OpenJDK now.
On the Java block. Yeah. Here's your stuff.
Oh, yeah, no worries.
So what I noticed was.
Because the Java login client test. Going just Java like, client library.
No, like tilt file
is my guess.
Yeah. Yeah. File in the
so I was connected.
Oh yeah,
Java login client
just
library.
Yeah.
Test
and then
so just using Java login client test dot Java. That's my current thought. Run the test using Bazel tag.
I just wanted to have one of
these.
There
you go. How would you recommend so that I don't have to
make it? I didn't leave the gRPC.
I guess
I can use the source every time.
Yeah, the only thing I could think of is maybe adding that profile up to your
test source.
So, like,
sorry, we weren't able to work
out.
Oh, wait, no, sorry.
I would cat it. For us, it was.
Well, you could just
point to that.
It was cat,
and then the file.
And I just.
But Albert
said something.
Copy one line of it. One just eight.
Yeah. So it's saying, like, basically, we're adding that.
Oh, I see.
And then we're going to do then.
Yeah, I mean, that's wrong with instructions to the compliance sometimes.
Then we add that, like, at the top.
But it's just, can people laptops?
Oh, this looks like it's all my Z shell stuff. So they have another bunch of like.
I don't have there. It shouldn't work.
I think so. Yeah, I mean, we hit the limit. So part of
that. So then just like add that at the bottom.
Integration test meant to fail.
Interesting. That might be over.
So I just run. If you add the data. How's it failing?
Saying like export path.
We'll be back with this.
Like, so you have to write each path every time.
It's okay. Okay.
So if you do that, here's a fun thing. If you double click on the line,
or if you need that, and if you need
maybe like my path,
like you actually need.
Oh, we're gonna look at the hacker ones. I might take a pick of classes.
So do I just pass? Yeah, so do like path equals dollar and path.
The screen that's placed slightly too far. So it seems like you're running another version of the server somewhere. Is that possible?
Oh, yeah.
So like, what was
yeah, so
what's going on?
That,
like,
you're stuck here?
Oh,
yeah.
So
if
the rules writing session afternoon, it would just give you, you're welcome to leave your stuff here.
No,
otherwise, like, if you want to be part of the discussions earlier, downstairs in the afternoon, then
nice.
Every time.
So we'll just keep really on
this. It's in your it's in your C shell profile, but like that runs. I think that runs.
Oh yes, the wild
charts.
Yeah.